Hi guys, how's it going? So in my last video, I talked about the new range of Intel 11th gen CPUs and how most of them are a waste of time and money, except for the 11400, which looked promising. I've now seen some actual performance figures on these CPUs and, well, I'm a little impressed. Now, forget about productivity on these CPUs, you're just better with AMD at the moment, and therefore we are exclusively talking about gaming. So we should actually be looking at the 11400F. Because the F SKU doesn't have an integrated GPU, and there's no point paying for wasted silicon. You won't be using an IGP if you have a dedicated graphics card. But the 11400F comes in at only £150, or roughly $175, but outperforms the Ryzen 7 3700X, which costs almost twice that. In fact, it regularly beats the 3700X by more than 10%, which gives the 11400F very nearly top-tier gaming performance. It doesn't quite match the very best CPUs when gaming at 1080p, but frequently comes within 20%, for not much more than 25% of the price in some cases. If you're gaming at 1440p or higher, that gap drops away to practically nothing, as you're likely GPU bound. And that's the thing, if you're looking at building a dedicated gaming system, you should always be prioritising GPU anyway, and with prices and availability the way they are right now, probably for a while, picking up an 11400F, save yourself £450 over something like the flagship 11900K and lose 1% gaming performance in 1440p Rainbow Six. Or perhaps more realistically, saving £150 over a 3700X while getting better performance, putting that £150 on your GPU budget, or possibly even high-speed M.2 drive. I know quite a few PC gamers whose system is used almost exclusively for gaming, and doing so in as cost-effective a way as possible. This is not a traditionally strong area for Intel, but as AMD seems to have totally abandoned any sense of value in their products, and the lower end entirely, which is their traditional strong point, it's nice to see Intel taking the win and providing a genuinely interesting product, albeit one that is easily overlooked and not very flashy. It is also worth noting that the previous generation 10400F is available at only £125. Intel truly have the budget gaming segment all to themselves at the moment. Either the 10400 or the 11400, F or even non-Fs, are great value if all you're doing is playing games. That being said, they probably both outperform my aging overclocked 6700K in Premiere Pro that I'm using to make this video, so there's also that. And Intel truly are the budget kings. Right now, anyway. So thank you very much for watching. If you found this video interesting, why not hit that subscribe button for more tech content?